sir.
Yes, I do want it back.
Yes, sir.
You have to articulate a crime that I've either committed, yes, I'm committing, or I'm about to commit.
Yes, sir.
You don't want to bet?
Yes, sir.
All right, well, you better call your supervisor if you do something stupid. You better go back and read up the law.
A big point of our brief is that we don't have to demonstrate reasonable suspicion of any specific crime at all. That the reasonable suspicion standard first announced in Terry versus Ohio decades ago only requires reasonable suspicion of criminal activity.
Of course, in the cases that are pertinent, very factually pertinent to this case, Keelan and Mochek, where someone's arrested for concealing identity, we say exactly the opposite of what you're saying. We say you have to have a reasonable suspicion of some predicate underlying crime. We don't say some generalized criminal activity. We say particular predicate crime. So let's assume that we're going there and respond to that.
Okay.
For me, if you would.
Sure.